Welcome to our final year project presentation. My name is Shevin Srivarna.
And I am Jamie Tadgell. Tasked with robot navigation, this is a laser-guided robot system.
So, what is a laser-guided robot system? Why is it necessary? Well, this solution is presented in response to the problem of odometry, the most common type of robot navigation that is used. Odometry uses motion sensors to update position changes over time. Typically, high-resolution encoders are used to measure the number of rotations for an axle. There are two types of errors, however, that accompany odometry: systematic and non-systematic errors, both of which affect the orientation and trajectory of the robot in question. Systematic errors are best described as errors caused by inaccuracy, which reoccur and therefore be made redundant utilizing rotary encoders and software. Non-systematic errors are random errors arising from wheel slippage and bumps on the ground. These cannot be fixed by odometry and accumulate over time over long distance. Therefore, we need a system to compensate for this random error. Something as simple as using maybe references to a known location which can remove this accumulation of error. The solution that we shall be exploring in this project is the use of a laser as a reference. Why use a laser? Lasers differ from other light sources such as torches and light bulbs. The laser light is coherent. This means, let's take for an example, two beams of light. Coherency occurs when the phase difference between their waves is constant. A laser, unlike an incandescent source, provides a beam in which all the components bear a fixed relationship to each other, producing a narrow beam that does not interfere with each other, making it a great reference over a large distance. To implement this laser-guided system, we use two robots, codenamed Master and Follower. Both contain a Raspberry Pi and a PSoC 5LP microprocessor. The Master contains a reference laser, and the Follower, the laser capture method. So this is the blueprint for our operation. The Master and the Follower will be in open space. They will not have information about the other's orientation. The space will also not have any obstacles. So our game plan involves three simple phases. Phase 1, Follower alignment. Phase 2, Master alignment. And the final phase, the dog-rabbit control. To accomplish these three phases, we needed to make changes to what we were presented with. We were given two robots built on shadow robot chassis. The Master contained a PSoC wired onto a Vera board connecting quadrature encoders and motors along with a laser attached to a server and an IR receiver. We removed the IR receiver as this was no longer required with our approach. We instead added two high-power LEDs running a constant current circuit controlled by the microprocessor. We plastic bent acrylic and added a diffuser to mount these LEDs onto. The laser alignment method from last year was made more precise through using a metal gear servo and a more custom fit horn sleeve, other than the force fitted version from the previous iteration that no longer worked due to the servo wearing out the grooves over multiple use. The Follower contained a PSoC, also similarly wired to the Vera board, with the motors and encoders, and 10 IR emitters with the mirror system that was already presented. We removed the IR emitters and instead implemented a tilt mechanism so the Raspberry Pi camera could also face forward instead of only looking downwards to the mirror system, which involved redesigning the top plate and moving the power source to the right posts. The motors were rewired due to wear over time and general maintenance was carried out to upgrade the robot to what it looks like now.
Software was started from scratch, interfacing with the components already present on the PSoC. We initially started the project using an interrupt service routine. However, we switched this over to a real-time operating system as the project became more complex. In a complicated program, a real-time operating system has advantages such as task scheduling, multitasking, system management, as well as inter-task communication. The main benefit that we took advantage of was the use of task scheduling through semaphores in order to protect variables if they are interrupted mid-run. The Raspberry Pi communicates to the PSoC how fast each wheel should be turning by sending a value corresponding to how many rotor encoder ticks the wheel should turn in a given time frame. This value can be either positive or negative depending on direction. A proportional and differential control algorithm is used to accordingly set the voltage applied to the motors depending on how far away the current wheel position is from its desired location. We used a step response to tune the proportional and differential gain values to appropriate levels, and also found that integral gain did not improve the response. An ideal step response should have a small rise time, overshoot, and steady state error. The robots initially find themselves in a situation where they have no clue about the relative location of one another. Our first phase aims to make the follower face the master by making it align with an LED light affixed to the top of the master. The solution presented from the last iteration of the project was the use of infrared emitters and an infrared receiver to determine which receiver has the strongest reading, and hence the direction of the robots from one another. This method was found to be ineffective at a long distance due to the small signals being received, which were easily obscured through small amounts of noise. We decided to use a beacon on the master, which would recognize even at a long range with the Raspberry Pi camera, and then align the follower to it. Problem was that the camera is currently facing directly downwards. Hence, we had to implement a servo enabling the camera to face both downwards and forwards. This required completely redesigning the top plate, as well as 3D printing a bracket and hinge to attach to the camera. Once the camera is looking forwards, we are able to spin the follower and use computer vision to determine when the LED light is in the camera frame. This is accomplished by setting a color range and thresholding anything outside this band. We also created a method to eliminate false readings by having a beacon that can turn either blue or red. So once the robot finds a successful blue reading, it then stops, changes the color of the light, and takes another reading. If the location of the initial blue reading is now found to be the red, the robot can without doubt know that it has successfully found the light. It then limits the camera frame to remove all other fake blue readings and is effectively able to track the light. A proportional gain control system is used to spin the follower until the beacon is in the center of the frame. Once this is accomplished, we can now know that the follower is directly facing the master. It is also worth mentioning that this phase does not have to be as accurate as the other phases, as if the follower is on a slight angle to the master, phase 2 and 3 will still work. The robots now find themselves in a position where the follower is facing the master, and the next step is to align the master to the follower. Our method for doing this is to spin the master until the follower detects the laser has hit it, and then minutely adjust the orientation of the master until the laser is hitting the center. Once this laser has been aligned, the two robots are correctly orientated and phase 3 can begin. The laser is detected through a two mirror system mounted on the follower. One mirror is half silvered, allowing the laser to pass through as well as reflect downwards. The other is just a mirror and simply reflects the laser downwards. The laser gets reflected onto a white canvas, which is monitored in real time by a camera facing downwards and mounted above the canvas. The follower knows the laser has hit it once the camera sees the red dot on the canvas below. It is able to determine the presence of the red light through a color range and thresholding, similar to the computer vision program used in phase 1. If only one dot is found on the base, the follower knows that the master is only aligned to the edge of it. It is unable to start phase 3 with only one dot present. The program then goes through a series of scenarios depending on the location of the dot, and the master spins accordingly until two dots are detected on the base. Once two dots are detected, the master is deemed to be facing the follower and phase 3 can begin. To save time, we initially take a compass reading on the follower and then spin the master to face the opposite cardinal direction. In theory, this would perfectly align the two robots. However, due to the accuracy of the compasses, we can only get an approximate direction. The master then only has to spin in a 20 degree arc as opposed to the entire 360 degrees as it knows a rough direction already. The major limitation of this part of the program is leveling the laser. For the extent of this project, we have to manually level the laser so that it hits the follower at 20 meters. This is not ideal, as in a real-world environment, we would like the robot to be fully autonomous. One solution to this would be to keep trying the start of phase 2, except trying multiple angles on the laser. The problem with this is that testing the full range of angles simply takes too long. This is an aspect of the program that we would like to explore in the future, if we had more time. Another potential solution would be to incorporate a Fresnel lens and instead of using a dot laser, use a line laser. This would mean that the laser does not have to be perfectly level for alignment, as the laser will be detectable at multiple angles.
Phase 3 starts with both robots facing one another and two dots detected in the camera frame. The objective of this phase is simply to follow the detected laser using dog-rabbit principles. When the laser hits the mirrors front on, two dots will be reflected on the canvas, one from the half-silvered mirror and the other from the normal mirror. The centroid of these two dots is determined using computer vision and are used to calculate the robot's orientation relative to the laser. This is done by projecting a virtual line through the laser points and calculating the angle off the x-axis. We can then determine the orthogonal distance to the laser by intersecting this virtual line with the robot's axial position in relation to the image frame and using basic trigonometry. Next, we can determine a point ahead of the robot on the laser line and then the angle from the center of the robot to get there. This is our desired angle. After determining the desired angle and the orthogonal distance, we can carry out a dog-rabbit algorithm. This is where we assume the rabbit, being a point on the laser, is always a set distance ahead of the dog, in this case, the follower. The algorithm assumes the dog wants to always go directly straight at the rabbit, allowing the follower to converge to the laser over time. The follower uses another proportional and differential control algorithm to adjust the speed of the wheels, depending on the difference between the desired and current angles. The slave will continuously sample the current angle and keep adjusting its speed until it eventually ends up aligned on the laser.
If you look back at the objectives we set for ourselves at the start of the year, I reckon we can say that the project was an overall success. The design brief says that we should be able to align two robots from an unknown start position at a distance of 20 meters and within a reasonable amount of time. I would say that we have accomplished these objectives and the robot is able to do this most of the time. We have also compiled a GitHub with all our resources for future students to access and improve upon.
One of our most triumphant moments of the year came when these goals were accomplished, and we saw the two robots aligning themselves without any user input. This is when the whole year's worth of work came together, and we could see the two robots almost autonomously find one another. The almost part comes in because of the accuracy of the laser adjustment. We were unable to implement a reliable fix to this problem through the scope of the project. However, we believe this is something that could be addressed in a future iteration.
Our current method of solving this is through the use of a server, which can cycle through multiple laser heights if the first one doesn't work. We decided not to include this feature in the final product, as this did not reliably reach the correct height. Over a large distance, such as 20 meters, minute adjustments to the angle of the laser creates a large vertical movement of where the laser is received, and this is not desirable.
So the ideas we had for fixing this problem could be through the use of an array of multiple lasers, so that multiple heights are accounted for at once. Another solution to the problem is incorporating a line laser through the use of a Fresnel lens. This would alleviate the adjustment issue. We believe a solution can easily be found in the next iteration of the project.
One of the lowest points of the project came because of the aging of the hardware. Since this project was started in 2016, some of the parts and wires have been pulled in and out and reconnected due to multiple groups having different ideas for the project. The Veriboard caused a lot of frustration, as the copper tracks had degraded over time, causing some of the copper tracks to come off the board. This created points where the circuit would not connect, causing components to not always work properly. One of the motors broke near the end of the year, preventing work from being done until it could be replaced. If this project is to go any further, we would recommend completely replacing the Veriboard, perhaps with a printed circuit board.
We both learned a great deal over the length of this project, including some technical skills in computer vision, SolidWorks, and electronics. However, we also learned skills working as a team, such as time management, problem solving, and the importance of communication. Over the course of our careers, technical skills will be useful. However, the main benefits we got out of this project is learning how to work as a team.
Thank you for watching our video.